I truly believe that there's two major factors in any kind of creative thinking. One is influence and the other is inspiration. In this case, my influence came from my relationship with Charles Schulz, who I have to refer to as Sparky. But the inspiration, the things that drove me to actually make the work, was about being alive. Hi, I'm Tom Everhart. I'm at the Mouche Gallery, and we're preparing for the exhibition of Raw. Having an inspiration for coloring books as a child, making my visual awareness more hungry and more active, made me open, when I was in my academic training, to the black and white works of especially the abstract expressionists. And I remember being so attracted to it as a student. I was picking projects around New York for freelance projects because I was a young painter and I yet wasn't supporting myself. And one of them was with a design group that needed to present drawings of Schulz's characters to him. And I took the project and had to learn how to draw his characters. But I couldn't learn how to draw his characters. I didn't have the training. So I didn't understand it, and I was studying his work. I was making Xeroxes, and I still couldn't understand it. I was about to give up the project, tell him that I lied, that I couldn't cartoon like I told him I could. And one night, I put a small drawing of his, accidentally, in a projector onto the wall in my studio, like a 25-foot wall. All of the outside boxes of the cartoon, the word balloon of the cartoon, was eradicated. They were gone. Because it was so big, all that was left was these ricocheting black lines everywhere. And they started eradicating shapes and forms, and they were entities into themselves. They were familiar to me, even though they were unfamiliar things for me because they were cartoons, because of that study that I'd had with the black and white enamel paintings from the abstract expressionists. It made me receptive so I could be perceptive to his work. And it changed everything in my mind. When we met, it was a cartoonist meeting a painter. Our conversations were really focused on solving pictorial problems in black and white with a touch of abstraction. This piece was to describe basically the thesis of the whole show, the narrative of the whole show. And it was what we talked about earlier about how does an academically trained fine artist be open and be receptive to the thinking and line constructions of a cartoonist. And that's what this painting is all about. You can see the representation of Snoopy representing the influences that came from Sparky. And then the wave is the wave of influence that surfed with. And that's why it's called Surfing with Franz and Willem. It refers to Franz Klein and Willem de Kooning, abstract expressionists who did black and white paintings. I was very apprehensive because I knew that what I was doing was taboo in the art world, what I wanted to do, to present a whole body of work based on a popular cartoon. That's how it was going to be viewed. Not that that's what it was. That's how it was going to be viewed in the art world. 8 years into our relationship, I was diagnosed with stage 4 liver colon cancer and went through 2 10-hour surgeries, a year of radical chemotherapy. And this is the period of time where the work developed, where it actually came out. So the work had to be about living, had to be about being alive, because they gave me 2 years to live. That was a maximum. So not only was that inspiration for me to start the work after 8 years, because I went, what the hell? It doesn't matter what the art world thinks. It doesn't matter what anybody thinks. I have to get out there and do this work. And so for 2 years, I painted like a maniac. And then once I was still alive, that's when Sparky said, we got to get you protection, and had the agreement arranged to show that I could use it for the rest of my life. Oh God, I could talk for a long time.
Should we talk?